everyone, Michael Davids from Bouffant de la Clare. Now, I'm going to be doing the first video in a series of a few videos to show you what wigs are available on the market and what wig will be perfect for you. So, first of all, we're going to start off with machine-made wigs. A lot of the time, these wigs are actually made for costume wear, fancy dress, stuff like that. If you're getting a wig for, if you're going through chemotherapy, I wouldn't really recommend one of these for you because they are actually very cheaply made. Here's an example. This here is a machine-made wig, and you'll see, if you just have a look at the top, there, I've got a pin in there, so, you know, that's... It's actually got the wefting through there, so it's not really that convincing, and we'll just have a little bit of a look at the inside of this wig. You've got a cap there, and the hair wefts that are sewn around there, but basically the wefts are sewn in a spiral to a little point in the top. So it actually creates a bit of unnecessary volume through there. The hair's not the best quality. It's better than what you would find at a party shop, but I wouldn't recommend a wig like this to wear every day. Another example of a machine-made wig is this lady right here. Now, she's a little bit better. She's made from a fiber called caniculon fiber, which was formulated in Japan. It actually behaves and acts like your own hair. You can't color it, but you can blow dry it, you can use hot irons and stuff. She is also made entirely by a machine. However, if you have a look here, she's got a permanent teasing put in through the roots. So it gives more of a natural parting than our other wig that I showed you before, the red one. So if I just get a brush, I can get the hair and comb it to the side. You can add a little bit more volume. These wigs are fantastic. They're really good, especially if you've if you'd like to have a fringe, which a lot of ladies do have. So I'd recommend something like this. It's made in a very similar fashion to the wig I showed you before, but the craftsmanship is just a lot better. It's like buying a t-shirt or a dress. You know, they might have the same formula to making it, but you know, some companies just do it a lot better. So if you can have a look there, the hair wefts go in rows through the top, the scalp of the wig, whereas the other wig actually just went into a spiral, and the hair just, it just doesn't sit naturally in that one. Whereas this one here, this will part beautifully. Now, this teasing in the top, this is actually called permatease. So if you have a look there, it's got that sort of frayed sort of look, and it will actually sit very naturally. If you'd like any more information on the wigs that you've seen today, please do contact me. All of my details are in the description bar below. I also design wigs myself, so if you have any questions, if you'd like to get one of mine, please contact me.